Goeiemôre almal. As jy het klomp van julle wat op pad is na die Bokker Suid-Afrika se jaarvergadering. Dis koud en dis nat vanmôre. Maar baie welkom. Ek glo julle sal op 'n later stadium daarna kyk of miskien nie die kongres. Hartlik welkom to everybody. It's wet and cold for this morning in Port Elizabeth. And now there's a lot of snow. Our first big cold front of a season. And there's also a lot of farmers on their way to the annual meeting of Mohairs of Africa for the first time in the Drosday Hotel in Grafenet. But welcome, if you want to watch your broadcast a little bit later, you're welcome. And I'm staying here to, we're still a lot of due to close down the season after the sale. I still got a lot of knots holes. And but yesterday, the sale was America. I was very nervous about the sale. The week coming up to the sale, I know that some of the buyers were not going to buy because their financial year end, the total offering from especially House of Fibre was quite big. And the reason for that is that the whole production is on the increase, especially the last two years. And I think we must make provision yet for that. The other problem was that in this season, it was predominantly relied on the two processes to buy all the mowi, and that puts a huge financial burden on them when the other buyers are not coming in fully fledged. Now what happened yesterday when I talk about a miracle is a third buyer, Mosen Falls, David Nel, came into the market on especially young goats and kids, young goats and adults, and it made a huge difference. That just shows you how what decent opposition can do. And it's also one of the reasons why the market, we quoted down with 1%. But there again, it's actually unfair to quote it with, to compare it with the previous sale, because the second last sale has built up this reputation that all the top clips is on that sale. And the buyers waiting for that if you really want to buy top quality, and it's usually an excellent sale, which was this year as well. And so for the market to only be 1% down from that sale is quite good. As I said, it was more or less a miracle. If you compare it to the sale two sales ago, is on the same bar as that. So that's a sale you all remember that dropped with 6% in value. If you compare it to a year ago, because we're at the end of the season, we always make comparisons, we are 4.5% better off than a year ago. And that seems to be fair. Which also, what quite good is that we don't have much stock yet after the season. We sold quite a good percentage yesterday, 90% from House of Fibre, and I'm quite sure that the other 10% I'm going to sell this morning. That is very good news yet for us, especially for the upcoming winter season, where the production is usually better, and we had some awesome rain, so the felt circumstances is very good. I expect a bumper season coming, so hopefully we will see the same reaction from the buyers. But then I can't neglect the highlight of a sale yesterday. It's actually on Monday afternoon already, when we sold the bins, a new national record for a bin bale. I'm very proud of Andrew and Rousseau in the milling section. They really put a huge effort into preparing that bale of super fine kits with a super style, good length. We don't quote all the buyer, all the farmers that is in the yet in the bin, because it's a lot of farmers. It can be up to 50 farmers, different farmers that made up that bin bale. But at 900 rand a kilo, it's the highest ever price for a bin bale. So congratulations to our House of Fibre binning section. I'm very proud of them, and they do an excellent job. People must remember there's only over 50,000 containers of Mohair going through that binning section per year. And they hardly make a mistake. And you must remember now with RMS, they must do can go back, and for every kilo that is going through a bin, they can say where it comes from and when it was delivered and what type it was. It is really a huge job. So congratulate again to them. Then to our top price of 950, yes, there was some good clips on this sale as well. It's not just the second last sale. I know from the start that 950 was the third highest price for House of Fibre of the day, for fourth highest price for the season, from Schalk and Andreas Nel. I know that they really put a special effort in the best bale that I've seen it coming from them. And congratulations to them. Really, yet a magnificent performance. Then the second highest price at 150 Rand, 920 Rand, went to Paul Michau from Cradock. And Paul was out of the top prices for quite a while. Paul, I'm glad that you're back. But what was interesting, this was a 25 micron bale. It's the first time that we sell a 35 micron bale, although it was a superstar, super length, very even, high clean, over 90%, a really properly prepared competition bale. But a 25 micron at 920 Rand, excellent performance. And then, as I mentioned, in the first place, third place there, the bring section at 900 Rand, and there was another 900 Rand a kilo yet from Lloyd Short. His best bale also went for 900 Rand a kilo. But then we can continue on the 26-27 bracket. Vidan Farming, Mark Wiener was here yesterday. Congratulations, Brett and Charles and Mark. Excellent clip, very good price of 643 Rand and 60 cents. Paul Michau there in the second place again at 643. And Mickey Phillips from Takastad. Mickey, your best ever clip presented. It's a huge clip. And it was so well prepared. And he really did get the benefit of out of that. The third highest price there for a 26 micron at 626 Rand a kilo. People, you must remember this bracket is usually for the young goats, because that is where the young goats are at the moment. The top young goats testing 26, 27 micron. Then your 28, 29 micron bracket. David Short there in the first place at 510. Ben van der Westhuizen from Adelaide there at 466 in the second place. And the House of Fibre bin again at 461 Rand. Really, most people are performing. Then your 50-51 micron group, David Short again, top price at 450 Rand a kilo. And then Abel Mello Trading. I know he tried his best to be there for the sale yesterday, but I mean, there was such a lot of obstacles in his way. Ayanda, congratulations. This is the first Black Empowerment clip that qualifies for the Miyuki competition. And it was really an excellent, excellent, excellent prepared clip. Superstyle kids, superstyle young goats, superstyle yet adults. Really a performer. And Mickey Phillips there in the third place again at 370 rand 40. Then the 52 micron bracket, Mickey Phillips again, first place. Then the Charles Moore family. And I know the Charles Moore family also got a lot of Mohair in that top bale of 900 rand into the bins. And dan Piet Skooman. Ek weet Piet was ook baie negatief voor die veiling met 32 micron teen 340 rand per kilogram. Mense, net om julle idee te gee, 32 micron op die vorige veiling, maar die top veiling van die seisoen was, was 32 micron gebouw op B330. Hierdie op 'n veiling wat afgekom het in prys R340. Mickey Phillips again at 358 rand en 10 cent. Then the 53, 54 micron group, Paul Michau again. Mickey Phillips again, second place. Paul Michau at 329. Mickey Phillips at 326. David Short at 320. Borden Lloyd at 320. Then the 35, 36 micron group, where a lot of adults was in, House of Fibre Binning again at the top, 312 rand 10. Paul Michau, 310 rand 50. And then Rolfie van der Merwe there in the 309 rand 10 in the third place for a 35 micron. Now then the stronger bales, and there was a few stronger bales, 37 micron and stronger. Droeboom familie Jansenville, ek weet, is nou onder 'n nuwe naam gelewer. Baie geluk julle, R305 rand per kilogram. Wieland Farming, also 305. Kobus de Klerk from Mortimer, ook baie geluk Kobus op 305. And then the House of Fibre Binning at also at 280 rand for a 37 micron bear in the fourth place. That's all from me. Hopefully you enjoyed this new shorter format of a discussion, and please let me know what you're thinking. We close down now. The first sale is only on the 20th of August. So everything of the best, and baie goeie seëwense vir elke boer. Ons veilingsomstandighede is pragtig, soos ek glo ons gaan 'n regtig goeie seisoen hê wat voorlê. Groete van my.